Hey everyone, Mitchell from MitchellGould.com, and in today's video, we're going to be adding the LinkedIn Insight tag to Webflow website. We're going to do this first by adding the code manually, and then second, we're going to be adding it using Google Tag Manager. If you have any questions on this, put them in the comment section and I'll be happy to answer them. Let's go ahead and get started. We're in our LinkedIn Campaign Manager account. We're going to go to Insight Tag. We're first going to start by adding the tag manually, so we'll click the I will install the tag myself. We'll copy this code, we'll go into Webflow, and we'll go into the settings of our site. And then from there, we'll go to the custom code section, and then we'll paste that code into the footer section, and we'll click save. And then we'll go to publish, so we can publish these changes live to the site. After the changes have been published, we'll go to our website, we'll refresh it, and then we'll go to this LinkedIn extension here, the LinkedIn Insight Tag Checker extension. We'll click inspect, and we can see that our partner ID is showing, so it was installed successfully. So your LinkedIn Insight tag is all set up. The next option that we'll go over is using Google Tag Manager. So we'll go back into our LinkedIn Campaign Manager. In the Insight Tag section, we'll go ahead and click, I will use a tag manager, and we're gonna need this partner ID. So first we'll go into Google Tag Manager, and we'll be in the workspace section. And we'll click this container ID. This will give us the code that we need to put into Webflow. So we'll grab this first code snippet, copy it, go back into our Webflow site, go into the settings section, custom code, and we'll paste that code in the head section. We'll save that, and then we'll click publish, and then we'll go back into Google Tag Manager, and we'll copy this body code. We'll go back into Webflow, and we'll now go into the designer section of Webflow, and we'll go to add element, and we'll scroll down to the advanced section, click embed, and we'll paste our code there, and we'll click save and close. And then we'll take this HTML embed that we just added, and we'll move that right below the body. Then we'll want this to show on every page, so an easy way to add this element to every page is you can right click on it and you can click create component, and then we can call this tag manager. And now that adds it as a component. So instead of adding that custom code each time, you can go into your component section and you can grab that tag manager and you can add that to every page. So it'll speed up adding it. And if you ever need to change anything, you can change this one component instead of going back and changing every instant if you added it to every page. So we'll go back into Google Tag Manager. We'll exit out of that. And then we'll go to tags. This is where we're going to install our Insight tag. So we'll click new. We'll call this LinkedIn Insight tag. We'll go to tag configuration. We'll go to discover more tag types. And we'll search for LinkedIn. And you'll want to add this LinkedIn Insight tag 2.0. I've already added it, but you'll click that. So now we have the LinkedIn Insight tag 2.0 as our tag type, and then we're gonna need our partner ID. So we'll go back into our campaign manager and we'll copy our partner ID under the I will use a tag manager section. And we'll paste that here. And then to trigger this tag, we'll want it to trigger all pages. So we'll click that, and then we'll click all pages. So the tag's been set up and we can click save. And then we want to ensure that we publish our changes in the Webflow designer. So we'll go back here and click publish. And we'll go back to tag manager. And then we can click preview. So this will check if our tag is firing as we planned it. So we'll click connect. And we'll go back to the tag assistant tab. So you can see our LinkedIn Insight tag fired one time. So that's behaving correctly. So now we'll go back into Google Tag Manager and we'll publish these changes so we can click submit, and then we can give it a name, and then we can click publish. So that will push the changes live to our container, which is added to our Webflow site. And then we'll go back to our Webflow site, we'll refresh it, and then we'll click inspect. And then you can see our tag has been added successfully. Sometimes it needs a little time to show here. So if you don't see it right away, check back in a minute and refresh, or open it in a private window, and you know, so your deleting your browser's cookies. So you should see it there. So now your tag has been installed successfully using Tag Manager, and you can also use Google Tag Manager to add other tags to your Webflow website. If you have any questions on that, leave them in the comments section and I'd be happy to answer them. And thanks so much for watching. Have a great day.